Well, good afternoon, everyone. Hi, boys and girls. Hi, moms and dads. Emas and abbas. Bubbies and Zadies. Clowns and princesses. Well, I'm so excited that it's the month of Adar. I think we should bring in the new month of Adar with some simcha. Here we go.
Mishe, 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 nichnas Adar.
Everyone!
Mishe, 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 nichnas Adar. Oh, mishe, nichnas Adar, mar bim besimcha. Oh, mishe, nichnas Adar, mar bim besimcha.
Let's clap our hands together. Mishe, 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 mishe,
mishe, mishe, mishe, mishe, mishe, nichnas Adar. Oh, mishe, 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 nichnas Adar. Oh, mishe, nichnas Adar, marvim besimcha. Oh, mishe, nichnas Adar, marvim besimcha.
I'm so happy, so besimcha. Now I know there's a very special holiday in Adar. And what holiday is in the month of Adar, of course? Pesach? Okay.
Ma nishtana.
No, it's not Pesach. Who said Pesach? Oh, I think I heard Yom Kippurim. Is that right? Yom Kippur. Oh, just Purim? Oh, just Purim. Now, I think we should all help each other out, and let's, who knows how to spell the word Purim in Hebrew? Oh, you're right. There's actually five letters in the Hebrew word Purim, but let's do it in English for everyone to help out. In English, it's also five letters, and the letters are P-U-R-I-M. Let me hear everyone spell Purim together. Here we go.
P-U-R-I-M, 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 and Purim is its name. Oh,
okay, here we go.
There is a happy holiday, and Purim is its name. Oh, P-U-R-I-M, 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 and Purim is its name. Oh,
very good. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna clap out the letter P. So instead of the letter P, we're gonna clap our hands one time. You ready? Here we go.
There is a happy holiday, and Purim is its name. Oh, U-R-I-M, 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 and Purim is its name. Oh,
you guys are awesome. Let's try two claps. We'll take out the letter P and U.
There is a happy holiday, and Purim is its name. Oh, R-I-M, 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 and Purim is its name. Oh,
you guys are awesome. Let's take out the letter R now, and instead we're gonna clap our hands. Here we go.
There is a happy holiday, and Purim is its name. Oh,
I am.
I am, I am, and Purim is its name, oh.
Wow, now guess what we're gonna do? We're gonna take out the letter I, and we're gonna go clap, 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 M. You think you can do that? This is the hardest one, so if you can do this, you could do anything.
There is a happy holiday, and Purim is its name, oh.
M,
M. M and Purim is its name, oh.
And now we're gonna take out all the letters and we're gonna clap our hands for all five.
There is a happy holiday and Purim is its name, oh. and Purim is its name. Oh, P-U-R-I-M, 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 and Purim is its name. Oh,
hooray for Purim! Let me tell you the story of Purim.
Haman walked down the road in front of Mordechai. Mordechai wouldn't bow, he was a Jewish guy. That made Haman real mad and he began to cry. Haman said, boo-hoo, ha-Haman, boo-hoo, Haman Rasha, boo-hoo, ha-Haman, Haman, ha-Hagagi.
Boo-hoo, Haman, boo-hoo, Haman Rasha, boo-hoo, Haman, Haman, Ha-Hagagi.
Next thing Haman went down to King Ahasuerus. Haman told him the plan to make the Jews toast. The king gave him the ring and he began to boast. The Jew said, boo-hoo, ha-Haman, boo-hoo, Haman Rasha, boo-hoo, ha-Haman, Haman, ha-Agagi.
Boo-hoo, Haman, boo-hoo, Haman Rasha, boo-hoo, Haman, Haman, ha-Agagi.
But Queen Esther was on to Haman's evil scheme. She told the king about it and he began to steam. Haman was sent away and he began to scream. Haman said, boo-hoo, Haman, boo-hoo, Haman Rasha, boo-hoo, Haman, Haman, Ha-Agagi.
Boo-hoo, Haman, boo-hoo, Haman Rasha, boo-hoo, Haman, Haman, Ha-Agagi.
Now every year this story we are to retell. Listen close to every word and you will surely quell. But when you hear Haman, you should begin to yell. You should say boo-boo, Haman, boo-boo, Haman Rasha, boo-boo, Haman, Haman, Ha-Agagi.
Boo-boo, Haman, boo-boo, Haman Rasha, boo-boo, Haman, Haman, Ha-Agagi.
I hope you enjoyed the story.
I want to show you guys my brand new hat. You like my brand new hat that I got over here? This is my very special hat. It has, how many corners does it have? That's right. You know, in Hebrew you would say Hakova Shali Shalosh Pinot, or Lakova Shali Shalosh Pinot. I'm going to put my... Wait a second. Okay. So this is my very special... Wait. What is going on with my kippah today? I'll tell you that much. Okay. So. I think I need some glue. Anybody bought some glue today? Here we go. Here we go. All right. It's on. Now, I want everyone to help me out over here. We're going to sing a song called Lakova Shali Shalosh Pinot, but there's some actions, some hand actions that go along. So this is what you're going to do. You're going to show me your kova, your hat. Everyone point to your kova, your hat. Very good. Your kova. Your kova is your hat. So everyone go like this. La kova. Good. Now point to yourself and say, Sheli. Now show me three fingers and say, Shalosh. And point to your elbow and say, Pinot. Because your elbow is like a corner. So my hat has three corners and it goes like this. La kova Sheli, Shalosh Pinot. Shalosh pinot la kova sheli, lulei hayu lo shalosh pinot, lo hayaze hakova sheli. You think you got it? All right. Let's try now. Take out the word kova, and instead we're going to go So we're going to go like this. La Everyone go la Nice. Here we go. La Sheli Shalosh Pinot. Shalosh Pinot. La Sheli Lule Hayu Lo Shalosh Pinot. Lo Hayaze Ha Sheli. Oh. Okay. Now instead of Sheli, we're going to take out the word Sheli and we're going to go Or two times, they're going to go, So everyone point to yourself and go, All right, here we go. La, shalosh, peanut, shalosh peanut, la lulei hayu lo shalosh peanut, lo hayaze ha Nice job. Now we're gonna take out the word shalosh, and we're gonna go Everyone, put your hands up like this and say Okay. And we're gonna speed up a little bit. Here we go. La peanut peanut la lulei hayu lo peanut lo hayaze ha Okay, now the hardest part. We're gonna take out all the words and we're gonna go for peanut. So now we're gonna go Everyone point to your elbow and go Very good. La la lulei hayu lo lo hayaze ha You guys are great. Good job, everyone.
Oh, hi there. How are you doing today? I'm so excited that it's going to be Purim very soon. And I'm just reading over here one of my favorite Purim books. It's a guess who book. You get to guess who the Purim person is. Mordechai, Haman, Esther, Achashverosh. It's a lot of fun. And I love having fun and playing games for Purim. And I've created over here my very own Purim matching game. Will you help me play it? Excellent! Let's get started. Over here I have five pictures. Four of them, the ones on the top, are different mitzvahs of Purim. We have over here some kind of a scroll. We have over here some kind of a dinner. We have here some foods and fruit. And we have here a tzedakah box. And then down here we have a man and he looks very happy for Purim. I'm going to put a picture in the middle, and you're going to tell me which of these five pictures match with that middle picture. Let's start off with this one. We have a clown, and he's smiling. He's got funny purple hair. He's got a green shirt on, and he's holding a cup of grape juice. I wonder what this clown is doing. Which mitzvah of Purim do you think he goes with? Did you guess the food with the grape juice on the table? I think you made a good choice. Yep, he's ready for Purim. He's happy and smiling, and he's having a meal. And that's one of the mitzvahs that we need to do on, that we get to do on Purim, is have a very special Purim meal. Let's try the next one. You guys are doing really good this game. Okay, this picture looks like it has some kind of a scroll, and there's words kind of written on it. It's yellow colored. Now, which of these pictures does this one go with? Did you guess the Megillah scroll? Let's see. Yep, you are absolutely correct. The Megillah scroll is the story of Purim. And it's a very big mitzvah that we get to hear the story of Purim being read on Purim. And you could even hear it two times. That's the most fun mitzvah, because that's the whole story where Haman tried to do not nice things to the Jewish people and Mordechai and Esther saved the day. I love that story. Okay, here's another one. It looks like there's a hand and he's holding a coin. Which mitzvah do you think he's doing? Did you say the mitzvah of tzedakah? You are absolutely correct. He is giving, or she is giving, a coin into the tzedakah box. And that's another mitzvah we can do on Purim. We can put money in a tzedakah box, or better yet, give money to a poor person. Or if you can do the mitzvah the proper way, it's to give two people tzedakah. It's giving tzedakah to poor people. Very good. Okay, here comes another one. Looks like it's some kind of a basket. It has the word Purim written on it. And of course, I don't think this man goes in the basket. I think the food and the fruit goes in the basket, and it does. And that is a Purim basket. Shalach Manos is a special Purim basket that we give to a friend. You can give your friend a beautiful basket with yummy, yummy, yummy foods in it, at least two kinds of food, and that's one of the mitzvahs of Purim. So those are the four mitzvahs of Purim. To read the Megillah, to have a feast or a meal, to give somebody a Purim basket, and to give to two poor people some tzedakah. Now, last but not least, is my favorite part of Purim. I have here a clown body or pants with some shoes and a red bow tie and a clown mask. This man, he looks very happy for Purim. But one thing he gets to do on Purim is dress up like a funny Purim clown. We put on his funny Purim pants, his clown pants and his clown bow tie and clown shoes. And then he gets to wear a funny clown mask. And he's all ready for Purim, because it's such a happy holiday. We get to dress up, we get to hear the story of the Megillah, we get to taste the yummy, yummy food at the meal, we can smell all the delicious food in the Shalach Manos basket, and we can feel the coins that we give to Tzedakah. So we have the five senses on Purim, and I'm so happy that Purim is coming, and I wish you a very, very happy Purim, and Chag Purim Sameach.
Can you show me, can you tell me what we do on Purim? We can listen to the Megillah. On Purim day, can you show me, can you tell me what we do on Purim? We can taste the yummy Purim meal. On Purim day, can you show me, can you tell me what we do on Purim? We can feel the coins for tzedakah. On Purim day, can you show me, can you tell me what we do on Purim? We can smell the baskets of food. On Purim day, can you show me, can you tell me what we do on Purim? We can see the people all dressed up.
Hey, look, a clown and a princess.
On Purim day, on Purim.
Now, I think this song you guys all know, and I'm gonna need everybody's help for this one. Your job, all the kids and moms and dads and everybody here, your job is gonna go rush, rush, rush. You think you guys could do that? So remember, it goes rush, rush, rush. Okay, here we go. Everyone sing along with Rabbi B. Here we go.
Oh, Chag Purim, Chag Purim, Chag Gadol LaYeladim, Masechot Rashanim, Shirim v'rikudim. Havana Risha, Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Havana Risha, rush, rush, rush. Bara Ashanim, everyone. Chag Purim, Chag Purim, Chag Gadol LaYeladim, Masechot Rashanim, Shirim v'rikudim. Havana Risha, Havana Risha, Havana Risha, Bara Ashanim, as loud as you can. Havana Risha, Havana Risha, Havana Risha, Bara Ashanim.
Now as quiet as you can. Oh, Havana Risha. Whisper, Havana Risha, Havana Risha,
Bara Ashanim.
How about just the kids?
Havana Risha, Havana Risha, Havana Risha,
bara ashanim. How about just the grown-ups, just the moms and dads? Let me hear you guys. Havanarisha, 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 bara ashanim. Very good, moms and dads and boys and girls. How about in a very low voice? Havanarisha, 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 bara ashanim. How about in a high, squeaky voice?
Havanarisha, 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 bara ashanim.
All together. Havanarisha, rush, rush, rush. Havanarisha, rush, rush, rush. Havanarisha, rush, rush, rush. Bara ashanim, bara ashanim, bara ashanim. Yeah!
What kind of a noise annoys an oyster? A noisy noise annoys an oyster. Why didn't the lion eat the clown? Because he tasted funny. What has four wheels and flies? A garbage truck.
Now I wonder if anybody knows the song, Hashem is here, Hashem is there. You know that song? Okay. Well, if you know the song, let me hear you sing along. Hashem is here, Hashem is there. Hashem is truly everywhere. Hashem is here, Hashem is there. Hashem is truly everywhere. Up, up, down, down, right, left, and all around. Here, there, and everywhere. That's where he can be found. Up, up, down, down, right, left, and all around. Here, there, and everywhere. That's where he can be found. Now, you know, that song sounds a lot like another song I know how to sing that goes like this. Oh, Am Yisroel, have no fear, Mashiach will be here this year. Am Yisroel, have no fear, Mashiach will be here this year. We want Mashiach now, we want Mashiach now, we want Mashiach now, we don't wanna wait, everyone! We want Mashiach now, we want Mashiach now, we want Mashiach now, we don't wanna wait. Now, you know what happens? Sometimes when I'm singing one song, I start singing the other one by accident, and it sounds like this. Hashem is here, Hashem is there, Mashiach will be here this year. Wait a second. Oh, Am Yisroel, have no fear, Hashem is truly everywhere, huh? We want Mashiach now, right, left, and all around. Here, there, and everywhere. We don't wanna wait. Wait a second. We want Mashiach now. We want Mashiach now, right, left, and all around. Here, there, and I'm so confused. We don't wanna wait. No, wait, that's where he can be found. I don't even know anymore. You guys are confusing me.
I won the Purim basket. I two the Purim basket. I three the Purim basket. I four the Purim basket. I five the Purim basket. I six the Purim basket. I seven the Purim basket. I eight the Purim basket. You ate the Purim basket? How did it taste? A little funny.
Well, I wonder if you guys can help me out with this mitzvah song then. Maybe you know it. It's called Willoughby Wallaby. Okay, he'll help me out. Here we go.
Oh, Willoughby Wallaby Witzvahs, let's sing a song about Willoughby Wallaby Wara. Mitzvahs come from the Torah.
Very good. You guys are good at the song already. Here we go, loud and clear.
Willoughby Wallaby Wazuza, on my door I have a Willoughby Wallaby Wadaka, with my money I give.
Very good. Oh, willoughby, wallaby, whoa, sure. I like to eat food that is. Willoughby, wallaby, waha. When I eat, I try to make a bracha. Very good. You guys are very smart. I think you guys are rabbis. Let's try some other ones. Oh, willoughby, wallaby, wabbis. On Friday night, it's willoughby, wallaby, Wendell's. My mommy lights the willoughby, wallaby, wofar. On Rosh Hashanah, we blow the willoughby, wallaby, wooka. And on Sukkot, we sit in a sukkah. Oh, willoughby, wallaby, wigilla. On Purim, we read the willoughby, wallaby, watsa. And on Pesach, we eat. Oh, willoughby, wallaby, one. Oh, mitzvahs are a lot of fun. Willoughby, wallaby, wazoo. And so is playing my finger. Blah, 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 blah. No? And so is playing my beard. No. And so is brushing my teeth. And so is playing my kazoo. Willoughby, wallaby, wong. That's the end of the... You're right about that.
Okay, so I want everyone to tell, please ask the clown to stand up. Everyone say, clown, stand up.
Clown.
There he is. Oh, right, he's going to do a little song for you. They can sing along. Light Santa Tanema, rotating Koleka. Light Santa Tanshevi, who light your door, who light.
You know, we think about the month of Adar and all the miracles that Hashem does for us every single day, you know? Hashem does so many mitzvahs and miracles for us, and Hashem is so kind to us and loves us so very much. So this song is called Thanks Hashem. We all have to, every morning when we wake up our morning, we all say Moda Ani, right? And the word Moda means thanks. So every morning when we wake up, we say thank you to Hashem. So we say thank you to Hashem, and there's so many things to be thankful for. Thanks Hashem. Thanks for the sun in the sky. Thanks Hashem. Thanks for clouds so high. Thanks Hashem. Thanks for the whispering wind. Thanks Hashem. Thanks for the birds in the spring. Thanks Hashem. For the
the moonlit night. Thanks, Hashem. Thanks for stars so bright. Thanks, Hashem. Thanks for the wondering me. Thanks, Hashem. Thanks for the way I feel. Thanks for the animals. Thanks for the land. Thanks for the people everywhere. Thanks, Hashem. Thanks for all I've got. Thanks for all I've got. Down by the shul on a Shabbos day, or when I'm home, where I like to play. Because when I do, my mommy will say, did you ever see a clown dancing around? Down by the shul, down by the shul, on a Shabbos day. Or when I'm home, where I like to play. Because when I do, my mommy will say, did you ever see your mora dressed up like a Torah? Down by the shul? Did you ever see your bubby sitting in your cubby? Did you ever see your Zadie crying like a baby? Down by the shul, down by the shul. That would be silly. On a Shabbos day, or when I'm home, 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 where I like to play. Because when I do, my mommy will say, did you ever see a Jew playing the kazoo? Did you ever have a friend saying that was the end? Thank you very much. Thank you everyone for coming today. Thank you very much. Have a wonderful Purim. I'll see you next time.